Switching positions on the gridiron is an arduous task, and for Jalen Hurd, he embraced the challenge and used his year of sitting out to the full capacity.
I had time after I had stopped playing for a bit to really focus on receiver and really get that mentality and kind of learn the perimeter a little bit.
To me, leadership comes in all different forms, right? But you need to have an offensive skill player that just plays with such amazing effort that everyone wants to be like him. You know, really the guy for us that does that is, you know, a lot of times is Jalen Hurd.
Well, my body was not really feeling that well at running back. I had a lot of injuries at Tennessee, and the switch has been great for me for to rest my body, and then I'll be able to play a lot longer, I think.
In 2013, Jalen Hurd committed to the University of Tennessee. Fans of the team rejoiced. 6'3", 225-pound, 5-star running back. He was also the number one player in the state of Tennessee, and him staying home was huge. But after having early success, something happened, and a running back who was projected to go in the first round of the next year's draft just up and left the team. The narrative created by the media and carried on by the fans was that he quit on his team. Right on the cusp of making millions of dollars, he up and decided to switch teams, and not just that, but switch positions altogether. This baffled fans. People couldn't believe it, and as I've kind of moved around and checked out footage while doing research for this video, the comment sections pretty much all say the same thing.
No, you don't f***ed up, don't you? No, it don't. No, you don't.
But if you've been a part of this channel for any length of time, you know I have a very different way of looking at things than most people. And I think, regardless to how this plays out, this may be one of the best decisions Jalen Hurd has ever made in his life. And I will attempt to explain why I feel that way throughout the course of this video. Feel free to disagree with me in the comments, but please do it like an adult. With that being said, whether you agree or disagree, if you enjoyed the discussion that we're having here, make sure you click the thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel if you're new. Be sure to click the little bell to enable your notifications so YouTube will let you know when your boy uploads. Without further ado, cue the whine. When Jalen Hurd was in high school, dude was a stud. Even at his size, he stood out in track and field, running the 300 hurdles, the 200 meter dash, and the 400. On the football field as a junior, he broke the state record with 3,357 yards and 43 touchdowns on the way to becoming a 5-star recruit. But he began seeing the effects of playing a physical style at running back pretty early on his career, as he suffered a shoulder injury in high school and missed the majority of his senior season due to that injury. Jalen had offers to Bama, LSU, Michigan, Florida, you name it. But he opted to remain home and attend the University of Tennessee, playing under head coach Butch Jones, who I know a lot of Tennessee fans feel a way about, but this video ain't about Butch Jones, goddammit, we gotta keep going. Jalen immediately contributed to the offense, gaining over 1,000 all-purpose yards in his very first season. The following year, Jalen exploded with nearly 1,300 yards and 12 TDs, but he also felt that his body may explode due to the pounding that he had taken on his 277 carries. This led to a very controversial decision. Now, at the time this decision was made, Jalen was only a few games away from being able to go into the NFL as a high pick, but his body was really taking a pounding, and he felt physically that he wasn't gonna be able to stand up to this long term. So he did what you should do. He went to his coaching staff, explained to them what was going on, and asked if he could be used a little bit more on the perimeter and a little bit less in between the tackle. And when your big bruiser back comes to you and says that, I'm pretty sure it sounds a little bit crazy to the coaching staff. They're like, nah, absolutely not. Tennessee had just acquired Alvin Kamara, who specializes in that very thing. Somebody got to run up the middle. And for Tennessee, Jalen Hurd was that guy.
Me and Jalen almost like opposites. You know, they call it thunder and lightning.
But the thing is, Jalen had done the research and it lined up with what his body was already feeling. So it confirmed with statistics what he already felt to be true based on his experience. He saw that running backs average 3.5 years in the league, and their value is pretty low after a few years. For instance, Le'Veon Bell, widely considered by many to be the best back in the league, has been fighting for multiple years to get a long-term deal. It kind of sucks how this is lining up, but the deadline for Le'Veon to get a deal is literally today, the day that I'm recording this. So his contract will likely be announced right around the same time I drop this video. And he's already come out and said he's prepared to sit out half the season if he doesn't get the deal that he wants, which is a longer term deal. He is widely considered to be the best back in the league, bro. He's only 26 years old. And the Steelers are hesitant to give him that long-term deal because they know that running backs generally, their prime at least, it just doesn't last that long in the NFL. So regardless of whether he gets the deal that he wants or not, just the fact that as a player who is widely considered to be the best back in the league, the fact that he's had to go to these lengths lets you know that the league does not value running backs at a very high clip. This is what Jalen Hurd was seeing. We also just saw DeMarco Murray retire early. I've heard people like Chris Johnson talk at length about how tough it is being a running back in the league and how your value is lower than other players, and it kind of sucks with the pounding that you take. Now, I had originally included this little clip in the video, but due to some copyright issues, I'm not able to. I'll sum it up briefly for you, and I'll leave a link in the description if you want to go and watch the original video. In the video, Chris Johnson is asked what advice would he give to young running backs, and he blatantly says, play a different position. He basically says that due to the nature of the position, you have to block huge linebackers, you take a pounding, and you're expected to do everything that receivers do, catch the ball, make guys miss, etc. You do a ton for your team, but on the back end, your team does not appreciate you and they don't pay you like they pay the other positions. The interviewer then asks if he would play a different position if he could do it all over. He doesn't hesitate. He says yes. She asks what position. He says he would have played cornerback. So this is common knowledge, and anything past a super casual fan should know this. Like, I'm not telling you nothing new. Meanwhile, cats like my dog Larry Fitzgerald has been in the league since 04. He made 100 catches and went over 1,000 yards again last year. Now, he's had to change his game, but it's very, very rare that a running back is going to be able to have that type of longevity like a wide receiver can. And Fitz is a pretty physical receiver. That's not to say that wide receivers can't take a pounding and end up having to retire early. I think of people like Antoine Randle-L, even though he's a little bit more than a wide receiver, he had a lot of concussion issues. Megatron retired early. Early for a wide receiver is after 9 seasons in the NFL. That's early. You know what I'm saying? No, I know somebody's going to point to Dez Bryant and say, well, he plays receiver. He came in the league in 2010, yet he can't get a job right now. But that's because of 2 main things. Number one, Dez has not developed his game over time and added to his game so that he would be able to transition into the later part of his career. And he hasn't been shown to accept a little bit of a lesser role and be a part of an offense like that. The guy I just brought up, Larry Fitzgerald, agreed to move into the slot, even though he really didn't want to. He did it and it helped out the team, but more importantly, he extended his career. So there Jalen Hurd is with this knowledge. He's at a crossroads. It's tough. If he just follows this path that has been laid out, he will make millions in less than a calendar year. Okay? But he knows that this path won't last, and he's not happy traveling this path. So he's got to make a very tough decision. Now, of course, most cats are going to chase checks. All right? They're going to make whatever the sure money decision is. Most people are wired that way. Some people, however, have a different mindset. Some people are more concerned with the long term, and they're confident enough in themselves that they could turn down this sure money and cash in even bigger down the road. Now, here's the thing, that don't always work. It doesn't. And every person who makes those decisions knows that there's a chance, but it's a gamble that they're willing to take. So who are we to look at that person and judge them? To bring it away from football for 2 seconds just to put it in another field so people could maybe see it a different way, because we have a hard time seeing this with athletes. I'll use myself as an example. I worked in sales for years, 5+ years. I was doing great. Number one salesman in my store. I was making good money, guaranteed money. there was a flood. I was in Baton Rouge at the time. There was a flood, right? I'm working at a furniture store where I make commission. All right? There's a flood. A bunch of people lose their stuff. It's a really sad situation. Now, in the furniture business, they're like, hey, everybody need new stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, and the store is, we're making hand over fist money. After like 2 weeks of that, I quit and came to YouTube, right? Now, that seems insane, but like, I felt bad. You know what I'm saying? I always wanted to. I was already building my YouTube, but I felt so bad profiting off of other people's loss. I just couldn't do it. You feel me? Like, I was like, yo, I'm making bread, but this ain't gonna last. Like, I can't live like this. I can't even look at myself in the mirror. You know what I'm saying? I can't walk up to a person who just lost all their stuff like, yeah, what you buying today? Like, I can't do it. You know, I ain't wired like that. So I chose a path that I wasn't making no bread at all. But I saw the future of it, and I knew eventually I could actually make a living doing something positive. I opted to go that route. It took a while. I took some bumps. I took some bruises. But today, I'm much happier than I was back then. And I'm more financially successful than I was even then, which would have seemed impossible to most people back then. This is the mindset that Jalen Hurd has. And as I'm sure he predicted, he gets a ton of hate for this. A ton of hate for it. And a lot of that is just, you know, Tennessee fans are hurt. So emotionally, they think, yo, I hate Jalen Hurd just because he left their school and, you know, they feel away. But not really think about Jalen Hurd the person. But you take a step back, think about Jalen Hurd the person, the decision he made. Most people, most reasonable people would probably be like, yeah, it sucks that he left our school, but I do get that. I get it, you know? So Jalen's at Baylor. He switched to wide receiver. He's dropped down from 240 to 220. Since Jalen got the Baylor, he asked the coach to put him on scout team, and he let the team know immediately that he didn't think he was special or different from anybody else. He's going to grind it out on scout team. He stayed late after practice, catching balls from the jug machine, worked relentless on his speed cut to help his route running, worked tirelessly on getting off the press, and just learning the intricacies of the position. He's watching tape. He's doing everything you got to do to excel at the position. He's now a 6'4", 220-pound, ex-D1 SEC running back who was an absolute beast, said to be running a 40 in the 4.4 range, has a vertical of 40-plus inches, and Baylor's head coach is on record saying that, yo, we got away with highway robbery getting this guy. I did see some of the spring game. I'm not sure what happened there, but the coach said out of his own mouth that he'll be working out of the slot position some this year and working out wide, and he'd also be returning punts. We're gonna have to see how this goes. Again, huge gamble. We don't know. But I love the decision because he took his life and his career in his own hands and ignored the bullshit that everybody else try to put on you with their expectations of what you should do. I think Jalen's gonna find significant enough success this year to make it into the NFL and eventually work himself into a starting role. The perception of him at this point is not good and is not gonna help his draft stock. So he is gonna have to really eat this year if he wants to be a high pick. I mean, he's a senior. He just switched positions. Don't get it twisted. This is going to be tough. At the same time, I know he's prepared mentally and physically for that. He's had a couple years away from the game, so I know his body has to be feeling good. Whether he's an early pick, a late pick, or undrafted, I do believe he'll get to the league at some point and work himself into a starting position. That is my prediction for what will happen eventually to Jalen Hurd. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments section. Am I completely tripping? Is Jalen Hurd completely tripping? I know some people will say yes, but here's one thing I think we can all agree on. This is gonna be amazing to watch. This is a great storyline. I love it. I'm gonna be tuned in, and I'm right here in Texas, and if Jalen is making waves, I'm definitely gonna be hitting a Baylor game this year. Anyway, man, that's all I got for you. Don't forget to like the video if you like it, subscribe if you're brand new. My name is FlemLo Raps, and I'm gonna holler at you the next time. Players, one. Yeah, I'm not no quitter, cause I'ma go, I'ma go, I'ma go get